Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode from InternMakers for the How to Get an Internship series. I'm Alejandro Davila.
And I'm Mariana Briones.
In this video, we want to talk to you about resumes and want to share with you some tips on how to have your resume very up to date, very clean, very nice, and always ready to apply to companies.
All right, so let's start off with tip number one. So tip number one might be a little bit obvious for a lot of people, but in case you're barely a freshman and you're starting off, the rule of thumb is you shouldn't be including things from high school if you're a sophomore, junior, or senior. If you're a freshman, okay, it is understandable, but if you're a sophomore, junior, or senior, most likely recruiters will be telling you, have you done anything in college? So if it is something really, really important that happened to you in your life, like you won a national competition, you won an award that gave you a lot of money or something like that, then you should. But if it's something that is not that important, we would prefer to take it off. Right now, if you see our resumes, it doesn't have anything from high school.
Tip number two, keep your resume to one page and have it always concise. Did you know that recruiters spend like an average of 6 to 10 seconds like reading your resume?
I know, and sometimes like when we go and talk to them, they just like see it and they're like, okay, tell me about yourself.
Yeah, so it's very, very fast. So yeah, just highlight the most important things. Like if you have some categories, like let's say projects or school or like professional experience, volunteering experience, just highlight those categories and just make sure to have only the important and relevant information there.
Mm-hmm. Tip number three. Keep your margins clean and make sure that whenever you put a title or a date, they're all aligned in the same. Well, you can use like the rulers to create your document, but make sure that everything is aligned. A lot of people have like a date here and then another date here. So make sure that everything is aligned. That makes it look clean. And also really importantly, make sure that your resume is grammatically correct.
Mm-hmm. No spelling mistakes.
No spelling mistakes. And that is something really important. Like every time I check resumes and that you check resumes, we always find like at least like an extra space compared to other dates.
Or just some typos.
Like those things really do count. Like you actually can see them. And the thing that I always do, and probably Alex also does it, is we give our resumes to other people, because when you keep on writing and writing on your same resume, sometimes you don't even see these mistakes anymore.
Tip number four, always include personal projects or school projects, any kind of project that you're working on. Well, anything that is like an extracurricular activity is important and you should have it on your resume. Of course, you should always try to have everything that is more relevant in there. But if you have something, like people think that the projects that you work at in school are not important and that we should not put them in a resume because like they're not professional. But let me tell you, they are important and they will tell the reviewer or the recruiter that you are working on these specific things. So you should always include those things. So also like if you have like some leadership positions and you're involved, like that's super, super important so that they can see that you are doing like a lot of stuff outside of school.
Also, to add just a little bit to that, whenever you're writing your sentences in your resume, make sure to include values and numbers and all of that, because that gives you like a lot of measurement. I'll give you an example. It is not the same to say, I am fixing computers, than saying, I am fixing 50 computers a week using these tools. It's not the same, because when you say that you're fixing 50, it's not the same as saying you're fixing one computer. And that makes a huge difference. So make sure to add numbers and values and also how you are doing something, like using what tool, and that will make a huge difference in your resume.
Also, if you can add, like, what was the impact of your work? Let's say like, oh, like this fix that I made, it was converted to like, I don't know, 100% more revenue for this specific
Or it reduced 50% of the cost or something. Yeah. Add all of those numbers, they're super important. Mm-hmm. Last tip of the video is to tailor your resume to each company. As we have mentioned before, some companies do have resume reviews, but the reason why we're saying that you should tailor your resume to each company is because normally all of the companies post their jobs, and something that we do, and it's a great tip, is you go in and look for the job description. In the job description, it will probably tell you the qualifications and the requirements they're looking for in a candidate for that specific position. So if you find some of those words, what we would do is grab some of those words and include them in our resume in a way that it fits with what we're doing. That way, if you apply online, a lot of companies have like these automated portals where they grab like resumes that have a lot of percentage of the words that they're looking for in a job description, if that makes sense. And that is why we're saying like you should definitely tailor it to every single company that you want. Also, there will be a lot of companies that tell you that they want their experience first, or their leadership, or their skills. It's just a matter of fact of who is reviewing your resume in a recruiting event. So just to give you a heads up that you should be changing your resume for every company. Mm-hmm. And I know it is hard, it's time consuming, but it's definitely worth it.
Yeah, this is when it comes very handy to go to this workshop events made by companies and their resumes. If you can go to one of these events and then ask them like how they prefer to see resumes, you can just tailor it and like have it the way that they want it.
Also, we're going to link down below some amazing content by the authors of Swipe to Unlock, Adi Agashe, Bars Didroja, and Neil Mehta. So definitely go check it out. They have done such a great job bringing you such great content like resumes, cover letters, and many, many more things.
Yeah, these are some amazing resources, so don't miss them out.
Every Wednesday, we will also be uploading a video.
Yeah, so stay tuned. What's the best tip you have heard on resumes? And comment that below so we can add that to our next videos.
Yes, definitely do that. And please share with someone who you think might need this video. You never know who might benefit from all of this information. So please share it, and we will see you here next week.
Yeah, thank you. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye. Thank you.